Okay. My bad. I thought the game was making me work through irrelevant bullshit. I have nice legs. Saga has nice legs too. I'm sorry I'm so irritable. I just want this game to be over. Like... This seems like the kind of game that would be narratively ended, though, instead of having a big climactic boss fight. Okay, now what? Come home. Okay. Telephone. Of course it was. How do they just have my number? How do they keep ringing me? Good thing it's a fucking payphone. It's running me up a bill. Oh, is this Alice? Is this Alan Wake's wife? She's helping me out of the dark place? It's Alice Wake, isn't it? It's Alice Wake or my daughter, and I'm pretty sure it's Alice Wake. Can this game just please be over? It is taking fucking ever. Hello? Where's the statue in the fucking park to get the shit? Where is it? Why is it not here? She said, go to the statue in the park to get the fucking photos to get yourself out of the place. I go to the park and I go to the statue and there ain't no photos in the place to get me out of the stuff. See what I mean? It's taken forever and I don't know why. Do I have to go toward the spooky, evil, scary humming? Please don't tell me I have to go toward the spooky, scary, evil humming. I have to go toward the spooky, evil, scary... Hello?
Is that really you?
Is it really you?
This place likes to play tricks.
Yeah, no shit! Oh, I was gonna... What happened to you? Comically aim my gun at his forehead, but I guess I can't do that. What about his cousin, his distant cousin, Sliding Door? What about his great-great-uncle, Revolving Door?
I need to get to Parliament Tower Plaza. Do you have any idea where it is?
This place is like trying to find your way around in a dream.
No, this place is like trying to find my way to the credits so this game can be over.
Like, there are many versions stacked on top of each other. There is a page. Describes Door finding his way through this place. I tried to follow the steps, but no luck.
Who is this Door person?
He's here. Somewhere.
Yeah, who's the Door man?
I've been seeing his face in my dreams for years.
That's great and all. Can you point me in the direction of the credits, please?
But he is much more than he seems.
That's great and all. You have a crush on your boyfriend, Mr. Door. That's nice.
Can I see that page, Tim?
Of course. In fact, it's the page I tried to give you back in the morgue in Bright Falls. Huh.
Oh, I see.
Now that I think about it, maybe Dor brought me here to keep you from reading it.
Oh, shit, you think?
Here.
Maybe because it would have given away the plot of the game.
I'm gonna keep looking for Dor. The closer I get, the closer I feel to waking up.
Alright, you enjoy that. Have fun being trapped in purgatorial agony forever.
Whirling Door walked across the rain, slipped tiles.
I really don't care, Alan, if I'm being honest with you, buddy. I sound like Lucas from RE7, where he's like, hey, buddy! Willing it to take him to come over here, we're having a party at my place! No, I'm good. I don't care. I probably should, but I don't. Right. He just gave me a thing to use with the stuff, and I can't use the thing with the stuff, and now I'm confused! Okay, where's this construction site? Where's the construction zone? Where is the zone of construction? Find the Door to the construction yard. Great. Can this game please just be fucking over with? Okay, don't go that way. Okay. That's fine. Where's the construction yard? Okay, that light's going buzz buzz, but we don't have the lamp thing, because we're not playing as Alan, thank God. We don't have any of our other weapons, we only have the handgun, which makes me think that we're going to... See, I wish you quit doing this stupid... Stupid shit. Hey, buddy! I thought you should know! Anyway. Construction salt! Found it! No! This is a subway, not the fun kind. Shit. And why are they giving me resources? Why are you giving me supplies? Because there's going to be evil, spooky, scary nasties, huh? Okay, that's fine. Now that I'm playing a saga, I don't mind the spooky, scary, nasty people. They don't fucking bother me all that much.
I made it.
Yeah.
I need to get up to the street and find that statue.
What, those just spawned there? Those weren't there before! Dick! I literally opened the box, there was nothing there, and I turned around, and then they're like, oh, now there's items! Yeah, whatever, wizard. Yeah, you're right, I did. You suck. Already. Stupid child. Suck ass. Oh, now there's dark people everywhere. Now where am I trying to get to? Find the shoebox by the statue. Okay.
There's the shoebox.
Shoebox!
The clicker.
Yeah. And the light bullet. Oh, shit! Sounded like the duck jester from Adventure Time? I don't know. I haven't seen Adventure Time in a while. Alright, now what? Escape the dark place. Can you not deck me in the back of the head when I'm trying to escape the dark place? You piece of shit. Rude. 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 Where do I go? Where do I go? What do I do? Where do I go? Not that way. That way is bad. Get off. But I turned around! Man, fuck that stupid bullshit! Where do I go? This shit is so fucking disorienting! Fuck me, dude! You see what I mean? I can't even fucking get out of it! Why do they do this shit? Why? Just turn me the fuck around! And then you try and readjust yourself and you fucking can't because the game is so mechanically poor! You don't know what way to go. You try and figure it out and the game punishes you! Why?
Enough already.
Why does it do that? Just be a better game! Be a better game. Just be a better game. Ugh.
There's the shoebox. The clicker.
It's rage-inducing. I don't even want to cut the shit out so you can see what the fuck I'm talking about. So you know my bitching is validated. I almost want to make you suffer it so you can feel what I felt. See, just do that. Every time. Just do that. Every time. Every time I go the wrong way, allow me the room to turn around and then I'm like, okay, I don't go that way. Don't sit there and have me be lost in an endless loop of dark bullshit where I can't see anything. Fucking dumb. Fuck!
Yes? Hello. You don't know me, but you need to listen. Hold on. How did you know that-
More like, you need to let me the fuck out of here, lady. Yeah, exactly. Okay.
Wake is in Washington. I could talk to him in overlaps before. My mind place is more powerful than
You see how I'm trying to turn around and the screen is obscuring my vision so I can't see shit? That's what I'm talking about. Fuck that dumb effect. I hate that dumb, stupid, warpy bullshit effect. Fuck that nonsense. Help him finish the story? How? Oh, okay. Alright, right, okay. That's fine, okay, I can do that. Mr. Door.
This is the first time I've seen a page about Warland Door. Who is he?
A door that stands between two rooms.
I'm sorry for being so loud, by the way, but, like, that's how my mind is right now. Like, that is the state of my mind right now.
That door is the center.
At least you have pretty lights and purple hair to look at.
With all the powers mixed up in this, it's hard to know who's playing who. Opening too many doors.
I think this is the most frustrated I've been with a video game in a while.
I can look into it later.
And in a lot of cases, I've learned to internalize it, but, like, this game is... Woo! Like, this is, You want to know what kind of game this is?
It is a mirror, reflecting all possible realities. The family of Gores have the power to shift between...
That's what kind of game this is. I'm gonna finish this entire bottle of vodka by the end of the stream, I promise you.
Maybe I can find a way to get back home.
To get back home. She's a real big fan of Journey, isn't she? No, wait, that's Boston? What kind of vodka? Cheap shit vodka that tastes like crap.
Alan, we need to talk about the
it is just a bottle of platinum. Solemn Worth.
My mind place. I've reached out to you like this before. But I understand more about it now.
You see your visions too.
That was Bon Jovi. Thank you.
I used to think they were ideas, inspiration, but they're real. Just like this now. I try to use them to make the story come true.
I am a cowboy. On a steel horse I ride.
Maybe that's how we could communicate in the overlaps. We could use this to stop Scratch.
Just try to copyright me, motherfuckers. Just fucking try it! You can't.
So there's a problem with the ending?
I don't have the ending.
7 hour stream!
It has to be perfect, but I don't have time to figure it out. I don't know what to do.
And I'm wanted! Dead or alive.
I agree.
Do 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 do.
And what exactly does
that's what's going on in her head right now. That's the only thing keeping her fucking sane at this point.
To make matters worse, this is a horror story.
Yeah, it really is, isn't it? Horror story has a whole new meaning once you play this game.
You can't tell me this is a horror story.
Yeah, no shit.
The ending has to fit the genre.
Hold on, let me do something real quick. Sorry about this. I mean, you guys won't see anything on your end, but I will on my end, lol. Because I'm funny.
I can't let the horror story take Logan and Casey. They were dragged into this. They need to survive. Non-negotiable.
Not just them. We need to try to save everyone.
You're looking at Corn, but change the C with the P? No.
He's a real person who I twist.
I wish I was looking at porn instead of this game right now, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna have so much editing to do. This is a 7 hour stream! This is gonna be like 20 parts! Average of 20 minutes per part. 7 fucking hours.
So the ending has to be earned.
That's 3 parts per hour! On average,
you can't build a case without supporting evidence.
That's 21 parts! I know how to math. Fuck you! I know the game said I didn't know how to math before because I was fucking stupid, but...
Well, if the ending has to fit the story.
21 parts? Yeah, 21 parts. More like 21 guns to shoot myself in the head with so I don't have to play the rest of Alan Wake 2. LMAO.
Not just a character.
Sorry, I know Twitch doesn't promote self-harm, but I do.
Okay, a hero.
Sorry, not sorry, Twitch. Play Alan Wake 2, you'll see what
I've
mean.
I've been through hell to be here. And this is my life. It
This is content you're currently indulging in. Just like I'm indulging in this fucking... Yes.
That's what we're doing. Here, now. We're figuring
whatever ounce bottle of platinum vodka this is. I've already drank half the fucking bottle! Half of it is gone!
This isn't scratches ending.
What if I get drunk on the vodka and then I go to get my girlfriend? I just like meet her pre-drunk? Just get more fucked up, more drunk? Amazing.
You're right. I can't do this alone.
I'm not drunk at all. I'm just like, I'm trying to find a way to like come down from the game because I'm so annoyed with it.
You beat this thing in 2010, Alan. And here you are doing the same again. You're a hero too.
Like, I'm not even kidding. I'm not at all drunk. I'm just like trying to keep myself in a positive mind space. Funnily enough. Playing through the rest of this game, so I don't have to play the rest of it being a pissy, fucking drunk, ragey asshole.
The ending will have to be dark, no matter what.
Nix the drunk part, because I'm not drunk. I'm certifiably not drunk. It would take me literally probably, like, at least another half of this bottle to get drunk.
The scales always need to balance.
That's exactly why, like, honestly, you guys want to know why I brought the vodka on stream? Because I had a feeling this is the kind of shit this game would do. I knew it would end like this.
Scratch could be here any second.
I could be playing Super Mario RPG right now!
I'll find a way to get it to you.
Did you guys know that I can do Sully Erna from Godsmack? Did you know that? Hiyah! For you, I'm alive! Alright. Now, let's go get the rest of this game over with. I can also do opera. But I'm not drunk enough for that. And I don't make nearly enough money on Twitch to promote it. What do you mean weapon upgrade zero? I had like 8! Liar. Lying game. Unbelievable. I don't believe you.
I need to retrace my steps back to Caldera Street Plaza.
No. Why are there so many shadow people? No! Don't bad touch me, motherfuckers. No bad touch! No! Spooky strangers. Spooky strangers. Where do I go? I have to check the map, but they're gonna be up my ass. What kind of map is that? I don't need the map for that place! I need the other- oh, maybe that's why it's called the Dark Place, because I don't have a map. That would make sense. How do I get back to the station? Is this the plaza? No, she says I have to go to the subway. So if I had to go to the subway, where the fuck is the subway at? How do I reach the subway if I don't know where to go? I'm trying to refer to the map, but the map doesn't bring me anywhere because it's the wrong map for the wrong place! Why give me the map for the lake when I need the map for the Dark Place? Doesn't make any sense! You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like they do on the Discovery Channel. Yeah. No! See, I like how I'm trying to find the place, and they keep obscuring my vision with the spooky, like, encroaching darkness, and they're like, "Oh, that's the wrong way, Saga. Ooh, you'll be trapped in here forever." Whatever, Dracula. Stop it! Douche! Do I go this way? Maybe I go this way. Watch it get all dark again, watch them turn me around, be like, boo, wrong way, Saga. Ah, I knew it! God damn it. I can't see where the fuck I'm going when you obscure my vision like that! Thanks. Wait, do you not take damage when they do that? As long as you're in that, like, shadowy, like, enveloped... kind of foggy bullshit, do they not hurt you? Like I thought they did? How do I reach the fucking subway? No, this isn't it. This goes into the... yeah. So if that goes into the... yeah, how do I get to the... Or is it a straight shot across? Am I dumb? That is not what I did, but okay. No, because this is where it got all dark and spooky and evil. I mean, it's done that in a lot of places. Oh, it's the subway! Oh, I'm smart. Haha, take that, you evil bastards. I missed a toolkit? No way. Dude, I totally missed a toolkit. Why give me shotgun shells? I have no shotgun! Oh, brutal. Don't make me go through the evil shadow. They're gonna make me go through the evil shadow people, of course. Come on, that's not even hitting me. That's like a mile away from me, dude. Come on, chief. Fuck off with that. Hey, how do I get out of here? Said you have to go to the fountain in the plaza through the subway. I go into the subway and there's nowhere to go! Why do you do this? What do you want? What do you want from me? I must have to go that way, but I tried going that way and there was nothing there. Fuck off! Leave me alone! I can't see you. Get off. Fuck you, dude. Get off me, rapist. Oh, come on, dude. This sucks! What did I get hit by also? I was grabbed by a dude! You're really gonna make me take health damage while I'm being molested in a subway? Come on, man. How evil is this game? Brutal, dude. How do I get to the place? More trial and error. Like, you see my health bar? This is how my health bar was when I entered the station. And then I take, like, two hits and it's like, oh, you're at no health. You know what? Fuck this game. Fuck you. Fuck you. Story. Return to the plaza through the subway station. Now, where's this fountain that I'm supposed to be looking for? What the fuck hit me?! There's nothing there, my guy! That dude is in the fucking floor! Where do I go? How do I progress? Like, what do I do here? I can't go anywhere. There is nowhere to go. Why would it direct me here and then give me nowhere to go? Why? Why do that? Parliament Tower Plaza, right there. Right fucking there. How do I get there? I can't go onto the tracks. It will not let me. There's nowhere I can go. What do you want me to do? Oh my god, this is the shit I'm talking about. This is the shit in this game that drives me mental. Why do it? You give me a directive to go somewhere. I go there, there's nowhere to go, and I get ass-fisted repeatedly. What do you want? Fucking horse shit. Do I have to eliminate all the enemies? Oh, is it a mental warpy stupid thing that I hear Logan's voice and then I come back up here and it reverts me back to the initial plaza? Is it some dumb shit like that? No, because this is the same area with the shoebox, so how do I get back to the place? I'm getting pissed off. This just goes to show you how fucking dumb and stupid and illogical this game is. I enter this part, it crosses the fucking thing off my menu, like this is somewhere that I'm supposed to go, and then there is nowhere to go. Why? Why? Thank you! Be cool if you didn't make your fucking door white so it blends in with the goddamn wall. Also, how the fuck does that make any sort of sense? I guess because, like, I took the door down there.
Alan?
Hi, Alan.
Saga. I finished it.
Congratulations. Can you write the end of the game?
And the bullet of light. Let's do this. I have to be the one to do it.
I feel like I've always been on this journey. Okay. It must end here. This darkness. What lies under the surface now shifts. A play of shadows catching my eye, thrusting my face into the water.
He's here.
It's shockingly cold. Past the mirror of the surface. And I will see.
You see?
A white searing light of truth that for a flash pierces the shadows and reveals the hidden horror. And in that moment of silence, the whispered message finally heard. Maybe it's a mercy, forgetting, to know nothing when we loop around, back to...
So using the bullet of light, I killed the dark thing and Alan at the same time because I just literally shot him in the head. So now the darkness can't come back and manifest, right? Yeah, we'll see if my daughter answers the phone so we can rip this conclusion into a positive fucking light. Doofy. Thank you! Oh! We did it! That's all it took! All we had to do was shoot Alan Wake in the head! It was that simple! That was it! Fuck this game! Fuck the people who made it! Fuck you, Remedy! Learn how to make combat, you stupid, fucking, dumb, illiterate, fucking, cock-sucking, fucking, dog-fucking, dumb motherfuckers! Seriously, this is the dumbest combat engine I've ever seen in a long time. The rest of the game was fucking amazing. The art, fantastic. The fucking story, it was pretty well presented, but it was kind of so-so. But the presentation was great. Art direction, fantastic. Jump scares were pretty cool, but they got really fucking old because you oversaturated the game with them. Your boss fights need a lot of fucking work. Your combat sucks. Cock. Utter dick. Really. I am so glad this fucking game is over. Now we can move on to bigger and brighter and fucking better, honestly awesomer things. Thank God. I can go back to Super Mario RPG, a game that I actually respect because it's fun and it makes sense. And it's intuitive and magical instead of being fucking dumb and oversaturated and overplayed and fucking padded with a whole bunch of nonsensical bullshit. Oh, man. I'm sorry, but Jesus Christ. Alan Wake is finally fucking over, thank God. I'm never playing this game again. If I could return it, I would. It took 7 hours to get to the end of the game. Took 7 hours. All I literally had to do was play through like 3 or 4 chapters and it took 7 hours. That's like literally 3 or 3.5 hours of progress right there. If I would have known exactly what to do and everywhere to go and exactly what to interact with, that would have been like 3.5 hours. So I don't want to relentlessly shit on the game, but it is most certainly like a 4 or a 5 out of 10 for me at this point now. So, what this game did well, it did really well. Like I said, the presentation and the atmosphere are fucking awesome. They're really good. The warping effects of, like, the dark place permeating reality and, like, going into the overlaps and stuff, and, like, the way the overlaps are constructed to be triggered is pretty cool. Like, honestly, it's a pretty awesome idea, and I'm glad they explored it, like, as organically as they did. But the lows for this game far outweigh the highs, for me, personally. Because when I look at a game in terms of construct, I look for, like, how fun it is to play, how immersive it is, like, especially the combat. If the combat is going to be a heavy element to your game, I like consistency. I like being able to learn what I'm doing wrong, and I like being able to adapt my style and be able to tackle things. And the way that I went about a lot of the combat in this game is, like I said, whenever you see me play a Resident Evil game, or anything survival horror, I will get an idea of what an enemy's health values are, and how much I believe they can tank. And I will blast them with one or two shotgun rounds, and then I will swap to my sidearm to finish them off. And that's how I regulate resource and conserve, you know, stuff, like supplies. So that's how I work my resource conservation. So to get punished for something that I know I'm doing correctly, giving my survival horror experience, and I impulsively, reactively dodge every time I see an enemy, instead of me having to compensate for how quick the enemy is or how far they are away, I would rather just whenever I see the enemy move, if I do a dodge command, register that I had input a dodge and just move me away from the enemy. Or give me iframes. Give me some sort of methodology to tackle your game in the way that you constructed it that assures me that my impulsive reaction will make sure that I'm alright and that I can avoid damage. Do not forcibly damage me when I'm playing impulsively and I'm playing reactively and I'm on my shit. Because, like, if my reactions are good and I'm dodging away from the enemy, that obviously indicates that I've adapted to the enemy's movement patterns well enough to be able to distance myself away. If I'm learning something, sure. But, goddamn.
This part is just for you. After the haunting started, I got in touch with an organization that was still looking into what happened in Bright Falls.
Are they gonna tease a third game? Please don't.
Photos inside a dark tide of madness, the same events and images looping again and again. And then I saw a light. Your light. You dove in just as I swam out. You never drowned. And you're still there reaching out. That is what the haunting is. I can see you because I've been there too. I chose to come back to the dark place. That is why I put on this exhibition. I had to mislead you, so that I could get you to where you needed to be. The only way out of your loop is destruction or ascension, light or dark. And we've covered the destruction part many times over. We're getting to the ascension bit by bit. Time means nothing here. You'll still need to go through the loop. But I will keep showing you the images you need to see, the light you need to see, until you're ready. Alan, I think we're getting close.
It's not a loop. It's a spiral.
I don't know what the fuck that is supposed to mean, but there you go. There's Alan Wake 2. Like I said, the highs of this game are incredibly high. The art direction is great. The atmosphere and immersion is fucking expertly done. The enemy variety, I don't want to say leaves a lot to be desired, but like a lot of the ways the enemies mechanically work, given the fucking limitations of the shit combat, really bogged the game down. Aside from that, the other things that bogged the game down are the unnecessary and tedious needing to weasel your way through things one little tiny baby step at a time is really ridiculous. Because given the twisted nature of the game and the way that it's presented, is it's very hard to in the moment analyze things and then know exactly what they expect you to do. Like I said, there's a certain amount of that is welcome in video games, and there's a certain amount of it that is just oversaturated and ultimately dumbs down the experience, and this game suffered very heavily from that. All bullshit aside, I would say it was honestly a 6 out of 10 for me. If I had to give it, like, a bonus point for what it did well, I would say it was a solid 6 out of 10. The music, again, was another high note. Like, the music in this game is very, very good. A lot of the characters were likable. Like, I don't want to say they had a shit ton of depth, but they were likable. Yeah, so that's Alan Wake 2. There's not really much more I can say on the game, really.
My sincerest and heartfelt thanks, if I had one, for watching this series. If you're sufficiently disturbed and would like to see more, I can be found on Twitch at Yamashi Yurimashi. It's been a pleasure, and hopefully you've enjoyed your stay in my cold and cozy crypt. When the moon glows and shines its evil light, high above in the starlit night, just before the stroke of midnight.